October Red. I am here with Louise Gibbs. Louise is a veteran in amateur boxing. I'm going to let you introduce yourself to our viewers and let our viewers know about your role in boxing.
I'm currently Regional Secretary for Midland Counties. I've been doing that for about over 10 years, probably a bit longer. But I've been in working within the boxing for about 20 years. Started initially working with female boxing a long time ago and got roped into it when my son used to box, and I've stayed doing it when he stopped.
So let us know a little bit about your role, Louise. What is your part in boxing? You've been, your experience, but let our viewers know a little bit about your role.
I arrange championships regionally, make sure clubs get all the information. It's one of them. They most clubs will, or coaches will come on, have the answers to a lot of things. I've been supervisor, I've done officiating, so, and I work nationally with championships. But yeah, regionally, it's a case of sorting out championships and answering all the numerous queries that we get.
Kind of like the backbone then for the amateur boxing. How do you deal with that? Like, such a big region to deal with. How do you deal with that, the organisation of it?
Midlands is split up into four divisions still. Each division's got their own secretary. So information goes out to them. They filter it down to the club. So there's less people to deal with rather than sending something out to 90 plus clubs that we've got, which makes it easier to deal with, make sure everyone gets all the information they need.
So your thoughts then, you came down to Acots Green, like you said, you've known some of the boxers when they were amateurs and now they've turned into pros. What was it like coming down to Acots Green and just seeing this whole event today where Matchroom have come down and done some community work?
I think it's brilliant. Been a great response. It's nice for the kids to see, you know, these boxers, they've been there. They've done what they're doing. This is where they've got now, you know. It's nice to see how the pros work and to meet the people and say it's been a great response from all the boxers that have been here today. I think they've thoroughly enjoyed it.
The influence then that, you know, amateur boxing has on the community, like you said, you've got 20 years experience. You said your son used to box. Talk to our viewers about how life-changing boxing can be for them and the benefits of getting involved.
It gets a lot of the kids off the streets. It keeps them focused. It keeps them fit as well. Whether you go and compete national level or want to go pro, it's a good form of fitness. To say, gets them off the street, gets them to help them a form of discipline, you know, and it's nice to see them going when they first start to when some of them are pros. You know, my son started, he used to box. He got into it through school. He stopped, so he would have been 13, 14. He stopped when he worked full-time, but he loved it. He still follows the amateurs because he follows lads that he used to spar with. So it's nice to see the lads he was, you know, he was in the gym, he'd spar with the FIs, and then to what he follows them as their pros, which is, he loves it. And it's nice to see the lads when they go from to that level.
And your passion for the sport, Louise, because, you know, you've kept this job, you've been in this role for 20 years. Your passion, your purpose, and why you stay in boxing?
I enjoy the boxing, amateur more so than the pro side of it, but I like to see the kids doing something. You see the little ones getting involved. It keeps them busy, keeps them off the streets. I just like to see the faces when they go from training into the ring and work the way up.
And in regards to like the amateur boxing getting like funding, say from, in fact, that is a question. When gyms like this are self-made, they're self-sufficient, they've put money in from their own pocket and they don't necessarily get any community help, what would your advice be to them? And who could Acots Green Boxing reach out to try and secure some funding to make sure the gym is sustainable?
There's a lot of companies out there who will sponsor the gym. You know, some of the local club community businesses will sponsor the gyms. There's various pots of money which the clubs can go to. There's people within within the region, there's club support officers who will help them get funding, and they know where to get it from, and they'll help them go through everything stage by stage, what they need, how to do it.
And would Acots Green be a gym that you think that would obviously qualify for some funding? Do you think this gym can get some help? Because they really do need some funding.
I can't see any reason why not. There's a need for it, and they can justify where the need's coming from and what they're doing for the community. There's no reason why they can't get the funding.
And finally, an obvious question. Will you be watching the boxing on Saturday night? You mentioned, you know, Yafwaiz is headlining a card. You know, the first time Matchroom's been to Birmingham, I think, is what, 8 years? 2018? It's been a few years, 5 years. Will you be watching the boxing?
I try to. We usually try and watch what I can. We normally go to my son's and watch it. So, yeah, it's a good night.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for your time, Louise. It's been an absolute pleasure. And keep up the good work, because I think sometimes us at the forefront don't realise what it takes to make the boxing's like an engine, and there's lots of people that are in the background that sort all of this stuff out. Without the amateurs, they don't get that experience to become like seasoned professionals. They've got a leg up. The amateurs like the leg up to get into professional boxing. So roles like yours are really important. So we appreciate that. Thank you for your time, and I'll see you again.
Thank you.
Hi, and thank you for watching October Red Boxing. Like, subscribe, and tap the bell for notifications. You can also find us on Instagram at October Red Boxing and on Twitter, October Red UK. And remember, at October Red, we stay ready.